on this side to sustain yourself, yes, but as in for the full-blown investment at Queen Eye Kingdom, no, yo. We there's no, like the brothers and brethren, we have invest in a spiritual bank account, yo. If you invest in this current society, you're going to lose because guess what? The stock market are going to go down. Nice. But the spiritual stock market, the spiritual investment of its profits, where it's going to yield you because that not going to ever fail you. That market not going to ever crash.
Right. Hey, y'all people more stressed that way. And we understand how come, right? Because they might focus on the world of things, them. And try fix what cannot be fixed. And they were stressed as hell, yo. I lose sleep at night time.
We are pressing in the kingdom, yo.
Right. Yo, we're so stressed. Because, we said, oppression make a white man mad. Right. You see me? But you have Jake. We're supposed to live it up. You have money. I'm stressed more than we have.
As we just have said, brother, you see me? This is 6. This is Matthew 6 and 19. Lay not up for yourself treasures upon earth, where moth and rust do it corrupt,
right,
and where thieves break through and steal.
Right.
But lay up for yourself treasures in heaven, where neither moth nor rust do it corrupt.
Exactly. It's a way thieves are breaking and will steal, as you asked me earlier. Everything we have, basically, the government can contact it at will. Right? When this economy collapse, everybody will try to kill one of them, grab. Even a woman, yo.
Right.
Even your own life gonna come to tech. So really and truly, no investment at this side, yo. The spiritual investment, the kingdom to come, yo. How everything I got alright. So from now, you get some money, alright, you pay your bills, you can come out for the highways and byways, yo. Sustain yourself.
You do that, but you don't put your all on that, yo. That's another way you treasure it. Yes, you have to live because you're in the flesh.
Come.
But guess what? You know, so your days a better reward and a better work to do than all the way out. When the color, when the half of the chip become the new money, right? Which is not far from now. What I'm going to do, can you have check out the mindset of you're not taking no chip? You see me? Then me saying it, they must say they're not taking no chip now. So what I have one time that become the new way.
They can't eat now, yo. So that means you have to prepare yourself to starve. You have to prepare yourself to suffer basically, yo, ultimately.
Y'all watching, y'all shy.
So analyze that. Oh, well, you're not just going to eat it, bro. This scripture refer to that hours of temptation, yo. So for the word hour, it just basically means season, yo, a period of time. Not literally 1 hour, yo. So you're going to have a season where I just pure hell, yo.
Without chaos.
They say them report, but the miserable revelation.
Hebrews 13 verse 14. For here we have no continuing city, but we see one to come.
Right. That's clear. We see one to come. We know that this society is going to collapse. So we've been telling you that Jamaica is a thing. Right? America get burned. We're still just them place our child there. So how are we going to escape it? Right? We could have come out here for a suicide mission. We know. Obviously we have hope. So what are our hope, yo? Right? Our hope lies in our washing our shot. We might come back with chariot them. Basically, I'm on the billboard. Hey, if you don't want to believe that, then you know, we can walk being chunk. Isn't it? Because chunk don't walk me, you want to walk there, yo. You have black people that say chunk on me. Chunk on the basically fix things, yo.
We watched the video of the brothers from New York comforting one of his works. And when I tell them, I think the brother Barack Obama, they basically said, we look forward to a kingdom to come, yo. We just know, say, yo, all of this our collapse, but we look for something greater, yo. We look for a life where we not have to wake up, hunger, Esau, work, but we can control with the children, yo. Everything in order. And I'm going to do a smile here because I said, really and truly, I understand why them people are bugged out there because it's imperfect. it really seems perfect, yo. But because, but and then me, because we have faith in our Bosh and our shine. That's why we are at ease, yo. In our sense, we get the word, right? And everything in that can prove, as a matter of fact, majority of scriptures, this is what we are right now, 100% faith. So I say, look how we just cast a boom, the Lord put his spirit power, take up one book, and most of us not even read it, or most of our life, give the understanding to it, and we just drop everything on the spot. That's it, yo, we all get one kingdom, yo.
And because of that faith in Yahushua being in you, then Yahushua said, well, in separate you married, you conquer the world. And if Yahushua is in you, you conquer the world, you already overcome the world. So we say, you know, attached to the things that are in the world, because Yahushua is in you, yo.
And you can see the if you remember Ephesians, faith, in which you're going to use faith basically to punch a fire with darts and the devil. Right? So, when all of them backlash that start reaching, not only backlash, I mean like
persecution.
Yeah, persecution. When the famine comes, you want to say, yo, we're going to catch free. Famine come. You know, I got this big turkey on the table. I said, oh, what is it? We're going to be tried, yo.
Right?
But guess what? Fear going to keep it. We're going to quench that dart to get strike at us through faith. Because we know, say, yo, we're not going to get more than we can bear, yo. That's how it goes.
That's what they're referring to. They say, yo, feet are the shield. And the shield is a defense, yo. She got the part of the warrior when he fell in here and when he chopped them come, he set it. When the arrow them fly, he set it. So that keep him safe, yo. And I same thing with the weight. I had the faith in the young boss and I worry, he was a look here. We can't suffer this, yo, because really and truly, we got the kingdom, yo. I same thing with the apostles them in the Acts. When they get beaten, they must say, yo, well, they know they're gonna get beaten for you.
They rejoice.
This is Revelation 3 verse 10. Because thou hast kept the word of my patience. You know the word patience means suffering you without complaint. See? So because thou hast kept the word of my patience, I also will keep thee from the hour of temptation which shall come upon all the world to try them that dwell upon the earth.
He said, if you keep the word of patience, you know. And basically, the word and basically everything where Yahushua teach you. So if we hold fast to everything where the scripture tell we, you, like with the whole fuck say, you will get a kingdom, the Lord will defend with. So if we be faithful unto death, all them things, if we hold fast to that, you, we just know so we are good. But if you 1 second in doubt, say, look here, you know what? Probably one something I go off somewhere after say, you. You just basically call the house a liar, yo.
Right. You can think about the man protect you, you decide to
your room. No, double mind.
You can't,
you know, we're married.
Hey.
You know, this is what.
Alright. Keep it saying, hold on. Right. Earlier we were talking about this. Right? This is called ICBM. Intercontinental ballistic missile. Right, so them here, you have major countries like America, Russia, China, and NATO, which are basically England and some other countries, basically have them here, then the possession. Basically, them here are the same used against America for destroy America, according to scripture. Right, so this is what they are prophesied. You know, if you watch the news and whatever, you see, America and North Korea are got it right now. And you see China basically about North Korea and Russia about North Korea. And you hear what I was Syria argument and them things there. This is really not time for the right now. We're at the time of basically war. Right? And basically there's no turning back from this war. Right? So very soon you're gonna see shots being fired already. Right? It's just that people not take the thing to see and they think that they've gone too late. But no, I tell you what, you warning people, say, yo, before the war kick off, get prepared, yo, because this war is going to bring what? Famine, it's going to bring pestilence, right? It's going to bring havoc and civil unrest among all these nations. And as we're not talking about the war temptation, right? When the famine and all them things basically come out, I don't remember what I'm going to say about it. when them say, yo, all who basically with the government to come for the bus them and leave Tivoli because they basically were making an invasion. And they don't know a lot to do this and say they're not the Tivoli because they are dead feet, right? So them say, all right then. And them drop bombs down there for the people them down there, right? But after that, them came to the National Arena and they gave some screening. And you know, a paper basically with a number or whatever, right? There's often that that's going to take place now, the time to come. Yeah. They're going basically take them to mass camps. In America, they call them FEMA camps. I don't know if you know about FEMA camps. Right? I know about FEMA. Right?
Detention centers, yo. In World War I or World War II, I think specifically for World War II, National Stadium and the University of the West Indies are the holding point for prisoners of war. A lot of people don't know that. So the attempt to go and say, a serious time when they have to trap assets and people when they are bringing this RFID chip, the Russian in things, and this is how they are to trap the things. But ultimately, it will come down to this. Because the superpowers, they are going to clash, yo.
This is the last. Not really, but yeah, not well, they're not bigger things. Yeah. When they drop, the power they may have, yeah. When them drop, if one of them drop for that Jamaica don't exist again. Get them, I said? Jamaica don't exist again. That's how powerful them thing is. Right? And you have,
you see,
whole heap of them exist. Right? And them name for America. Right? So you go have calamities on both sides of the war, but mainly America gonna turn to ashes. And we're talking all about Russia, we're talking about fire from Babylon. The scripture basically, you said the fire, the scripture talk about from Babylon.
But the kings are the meter of a burn and basically the king of Babylon. Right?
This is 2 Ezra chapter 15 verse 41. Fire and hail and flying swords.
Right, it's a flying sword. This, the word sword means destruction. Because people hear the word sword, them things say, oh.
Every time
some man drop from a shield and goes and chop a man. Right? The sword they always talk about, a sword just means destruction, right? So this is the weapon that's going to bring destruction to America. And it goes fly. I'm saying they have intercontinental ballistic missiles. They will travel from continent to continent. Right? So you know how far Russia they're from America? In the east, America in the west. So they're going to left from America, from Russia,
China.
Going in the sky, shed every shed, basically, and then fall from America like shooting stars. Right? They're going to burn or come in the atmosphere. I'm falling from America, go on.
Because even when the prophets, them basically, they hear about fire and brimstone. When them see the visions, them here would have been the modern day fire and brimstone. If you know about ancient societies, we used to have one big ball with them. Quote you thing on them pitch one black liquid substance or flammable and then basically light it and put it on the pulley and chop it and fly. Yeah. The fire, I basically the literal fire, but the pitch, the black thing with them line it with, it make out a limestone and they used to refer to it as brimstone, right? And it's the fuel. So when the prophet basically say all the missile them come across, the only thing you could have equated to are basically when no
right.
Fire and brimstone.
As I brought that back again, as we said earlier, missiles will get named brimstone. Yeah, so yeah. White man know him and do some name some of the missiles them name for brimstone.
So
yeah, some of them call
they refer to them as arrows as well.
Right, cut.
Because even in a psalm you tell about the most I go shoot at them, I'm gonna arch and pull back in four. And I basically can't stop it. They have a movie named Broken Arrow with gun about basically one of these missiles.
Right? So they can call them arrows as well. So on the altar, our literal sword, our literal arrow.
Right?
All right, temple. He said, and many waters, that all fields may be filled, and all rivers with the abundance of good waters. And they shall break down the cities and walls, mountains and hills.
Like we said yesterday, a sword door. Chop down mountain. They can't have to down mountain. When them here chop, all mountain are flat. Right? That's all serious
engineering. What? The first company, our weapons company, and basically have a power.